In this video, I'm going to explain basic anatomy of hip joint ligaments. And in second part, I will explain important relationship with hip ligaments. Basically, there are three main ligaments in hip joint. This one, and if I go to posterior, there's other one. So we have three main ligaments. So what is this ligament? This ligament attaches on the ilium and femur. So this is iliofemoral ligament because it attaches on ilium and femur. Iliofemoral ligament. So how about this one? This one attaches on pubis and femur. So this is pubofemoral ligament. Pubofemoral ligament. This one was iliofemoral ligament. This is pubofemoral ligament. By the way, I couldn't prepare the tape right here. There's also a ligament. Iliofemoral ligament continues to the this part. But, you know, since this tape is not wide enough, I couldn't prepare here. But in reality, there is ligament here as well. So I will flip this model. Then you see the back side of the hip joint. Please ignore this green tape right now. I will explain later. So this is posterior part of hip joint. What is this part? This is ischium. This ligament connects ischium and femur. So this is ischiofemoral ligament. Of course, there is a ligament as well. Due to width of this tape, I couldn't prepare this part. Of course, there's ligament as well. Anyway, this is ischiofemoral ligament. Easy, right? Three parts. Ischiofemoral ligament. I go back to anterior part. Let's see. Then, on anterior part, there is iliofemoral ligament and pubofemoral ligament. Simple enough, right? So in next part, I will explain important relationship with hip ligaments. So in this part, I will show you the four muscles which have very close relationship with hip ligaments. So I will explain this one first. This red tape is rectus femoris. Rectus femoris originates from pelvis. But mainly, rectus femoris originates from this bony part. This is AIIS, anterior inferior iliac spine, AIIS. It originates like this. But this part has cross relationship with iliofemoral ligament. The main fiber attaches here, but kind of minor fiber attaches on below the AIIS. This part has relationship with iliofemoral ligament. So imagine, what if rectus femoris gets tight? It can affect iliofemoral ligament. Or if iliofemoral ligament got dysfunction, it can affect rectus femoris. Very interesting, right? The second one is this yellow one. This yellow one is not a muscle. This is a membrane which covers this hole. This is obturator membrane. Obturator membrane. This membrane has relationship with pubofemoral ligament. It's very close, right? Plus, there are two muscles attaching on obturator membrane. On anterior part of this membrane, obturator externus attaches. And posterior to obturator membrane, obturator internus attaches here. So one of these structures gets tight, it can affect pubofemoral ligament. Maybe obturator externus, obturator membrane, or obturator internus. These four structures, including a pubofemoral ligament, can affect hip mobility. This is very interesting place. I like this place. So yellow one, obturator membrane. Let's go to this blue one. This is one of quadriceps as well, like rectus femoris. This is vastus lateralis. Vastus lateralis is on the lateral side of the thigh. So this vastus lateralis has relationship with iliofemoral ligament. You know, there's of course a ligament here. So this has relationship with iliofemoral ligament. At last, this green one, this is gluteus minimus. Gluteus minimus. Gluteus minimus also has relationship with hip ligaments. You know, gluteus minimus is the deepest muscle among gluteal muscles. It's deeper than gluteus medius and it's deeper than gluteus maximus. I love these four structures and relationship with hip ligaments. If one of these muscles get tight, it can affect hip ligament. Then this can affect hip mobility. Why? Because ligaments support joint. If ligament or joint gets stuck or like this, is that moving very well? I don't think so. So maybe muscles get tight. Or in some people, ligaments get dysfunction. I don't know which one causes which. It's like a egg or chicken question. But if you think about ligaments and muscles in addition to your basic knowledge, I hope this information can help your understanding of hip joint. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.